Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name is Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is the Ubiquiti Cloud Gateway Fiber, the UCG Fiber. So, not going to be a big technical overview. The actual construction of this is very similar to the UXG Fiber, so do make sure you know which one you want. The UCG Fiber runs all the Ubiquiti applications in it. The UXG Fiber, you need to have something like a Cloud Key Gen 2 Plus or running the software on a computer to manage and control it. So do make sure you get the one that meets your needs. So let's head on over to what we get in the box. So we're going to get our Get Started guide. Some of you probably won't open that at all, but it does have some useful information in it. We're going to get a 30 centimeter Ether lighting cable. We're going to get our mains power cord. We're here in Australia, so there's our Australian power connector at this side. And we've got our cloverleaf Mickey Mouse IEC connector here. Then we're going to have our power pack. Obviously our mains in at this point and our power out to the unit, probably almost 2 meters in that. Then we are going to get a little packet of feet for mounting on the back of the unit. Now, I think you could probably fix those on yourself, but Ubiquiti have given you a little fixing guide if you want to. You can place that on the bottom of the unit. Then basically you can push the feet through to make them stick in exactly the right place so you can get them all nicely lined up on the bottom. So up to you if you're gonna use that. I'll leave that up to you. And then the unit itself. So one way to know that this is the Cloud Gateway version is because we've got our LCD control panel on the front, which once set up gives us some useful information. Do remember that out of the box, this turns itself off at nighttime. And so your unit is not generally faulty. It's just that this screen will, I think, is off between 8 and 8 or something like that. So do, if you're not sure, go into the settings and make sure that you don't think the unit's faulty just because the screen isn't on. For reference, this is the UCG Max, just to give you a size difference so you can see the difference between those two. So this device, polycarbonate construction, theoretically can do up to about 5 gigabits a second of throughput. Exciting because it has a PoE port, which we'll have a look at in a moment. So nothing on the top, not really, I'll show you a bit around the sides in a minute. On the bottom, we've got these vents. Now this unit does have a fan in it. After several hours of running, we still had to put our head almost pretty much right next to this to be able to hear the fan. I'm sure it does spin up a little bit louder as it heats up, but I think you're going to not really notice that fan really running at all on there. On this side here, we have our NVMe slot. You can use your Ubiquiti quick release tool to push in there, and that will release. Let me just reach to grab one of those here and show you how that is. You will need to then purchase the optional sled, which then will slide in there. And the stats say you can put up to 2 terabytes of NVMe in there. And we have customers on the UCG Max that have been able to take that further. So something that you can have a look at that point in time. So that's where we can now put our onboard storage. That then allows us to run UniFi Protect. UniFi Network will run without the storage. UniFi Access will take advantage of the storage as well. So we can now actually make this. I think it can support something like 4 or 5 4K cameras, about 8 2K cameras and 15 HD cameras. So quite a nice little unit for what you want. But most people are wanting to say, what is on the back? So this is how it is. We have our reset hole over here. We have our mains in on this side. We have 2 10 gig SFP ports, one for WAN, one for LAN. Now do remember that you can use many of these ports to have a multiple WAN scenario if you want to as well. We then have a 10 gigabit a second Ethernet port, and the rest of these ports a 2.5 gig Ethernet ports. One of these ports, really exciting as you can see here, is a PoE plus port, and this can give out up to 30 watts of power. So again, in the box, we can plug in an access point directly to this. We don't need a PoE injector or a PoE switch. So we've actually got a really nice all-in-one unit there. So hopefully that's been useful to see what is in the box for that. Do head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got plenty more box openings on network, firewall, wireless, and camera security. How to set up things like the UCG Fiber, yeah, set up UniFi Network or set up UniFi Protect. So head on over there, subscribe, and stay up to date.